Hello my dear students, welcome back. This is the third video of chapter 1, that is food for plants. In the previous two videos we have discussed all the topics related to chapter 1, and in this video we are going to discuss the question answer, that is short question answer, long question answer and say aloud also, which is given on page number 13. So first we will discuss short, then long and then say aloud. Okay, so without wasting, let's start our video. Before starting this video, I would like to say that when you want to write your answer and you are knowing, then there is no need to write same answer which I have provided to you. Okay, please frame your answer in your own language. Okay, it's not necessary the same answer it should be, but it should be correct. Okay, when you want to write your own answer, okay, just frame it in your own language, but that must be correct. You will receive the full marks. Okay, so please develop your skill writing. Okay, I am making this video only to help, but if you are able to write your own answer, then you can. So let's start our question answer. First question is asking, what is chlorophyll? Okay, I have explained you, chlorophyll is a green pigment. Okay, it is not only the pigment, but it is green color pigment, which is providing green color to the plant. Okay, that means it is very, very important to note down, only the green plants have the chlorophyll. Non-green plant or the other color, okay, pigment is known as the other name, but only the green color pigment is known as chlorophyll. So chlorophyll is a substance or the pigment which provide green color to the plant. Okay, question number 2, why are leaves green in color? The same question is asking, but in the previous one it was asking what is chlorophyll, and in this question it is asking the color of the green is due to with substance. So the answer is chlorophyll. Okay, chlorophyll provide green color to the plant. Okay, these are the short answer questions, so try to complete your answer in one or two sentences. Question number 3 is, where do plants store their extra food? Okay, remember when I was explaining, I told you plants are able to store their extra food in the form of starch in any of the body part. Okay, it can store in the root, it can store in the stem, flower, seed and so on. But yes, of course, every plant store their food in a particular body part, means one plant cannot store their food in every plant. Only one part will store plant which we use to eat as a food, and some of the plant which don't produce any flower or any fruit, in that, in the leaf they store. Leaf also store, but some special part is also able to store some extra food. Okay, for example, we used to eat carrot. Carrot is actually the root, and carrot plant store the food in root. Cabbage. Cabbage is a leaf. Okay, it is a modified leaf, and in the leaf the food is stored. The cauliflower. Cauliflower is actually the flower in which the plant has stored the food in the form of starch, and we are eating as a food. So here only you have to write which parts are used to store the food. Plants store their extra food, that is starch, in the different body parts like roots, stems, leaves, flower, etc. Question number 4 is, what is the food prepared by plant used? Now question is asking why they use, how they use these food. Okay, whatever food they are prepared in, they are preparing in the form of glucose, how they use these food. So in the beginning of this chapter, I told you the food is used to get the energy, and it is also used to provide the growth of the body. Okay, not only in the plant, but each and every living being. Okay, plant also use these energy in the form of growth or in the form of doing their daily activities. Okay, they also have to do a lot of work, and for that they need energy. So food are prepared in the form of glucose, are used to get the energy and to provide growth. Some extra food is always stored in the form of starch, okay, that are used later on. The same answer is written here. Food prepared by plants is used to get energy and for their growth. Extra food is stored in the form of starch in the different body parts. Question number 5 is, what is a food chain? Okay, what is food chain? It is a chain that shows the dependency of one organism, one living being on another. For example, here the insect or the grasshopper is depending on the plant or the grasses. In the same way, frog also depend on the insects, and snake also eat and depend on the frog, and eagle depend on the snake. Okay, so it is a series in which it is showing the dependency, okay, for their food. This is a food chain. Food chain is the dependency of one living thing on another living thing for food. Now keep in the mind in this question, my dear, this question is asking about the food chain, not the energy flow. Yes, both are related to each other, but when the question will be about the energy flow, then you will use the word energy. But in this question, the food chain is asking. It is asked by about food chain. So you will use the dependency for the food, not for the energy. Okay. Yes, of course, the food is only the source of energy. But in this question, you will explain from the point of view of food. Now, we are going to discuss long answer question. Now these questions will have little long answers because these questions will carry more than 3 marks. Okay, so according to that you all have to frame the answer. Okay, that's why you are saying the answer is little longer. First question is asking, explain the parts of the leaf. What are the parts of the leaf? As you can see in this picture, first part is lamina. Second is petiole or leaf stalk, both are same. Veins, which is side veins. And next is midrib or the main vein. Veins are of two types. First is present in between of the leaf, like this. This is known as midrib, okay? And in the side also the veins are present, which is known as veins, or side veins also you can write. And the most important part of the plant leaf is stomata. These you can see. Okay, this is the pore. Okay, this pore is known as stoma in a singular form, and in the plural form it is known as stomata. This is also the part of the leaf. So only you cannot write only the name, okay, because this is the long answer question. So please try to write one line about each and every part of the leaf, like leaf blade. Leaf blade is flat and thin part of the leaf. Main vein and side vein, I have already explained. These main vein and side vein carry water and minerals, okay, for the photosynthesis. It also carry food prepared in the leaf. Two work are there of these veins. First of all, they carry water and mineral, which is used to prepare the food. When the food is prepared in the leaf, then after it is carried to each and every part of the plant with the help of main vein and side vein. So these two functions are there with the main vein and side vein. Okay, that's why I have written these carry water, minerals and prepared food for the plant. Next is the stomata. These are the tiny pores which is present on the surface of the leaf, and main function is to exchange the carbon dioxide and oxygen. Okay, one more function is there, that is transpiration. The stomata help to lose the extra water also, but here it will go very long. So one function you can write in this heading. Now last one is a stalk. Okay, if you will see this part, okay, this part is the connecting part of the leaf. This is leaf and this is a stem. Okay, so this leaf stalk is connecting the leaf with the stem. So it is the part which attach leaf to the stem. Okay, so these are the part, main part of the leaf, and about the a short explanation about each and every part. Question number 2 is, explain the process of photosynthesis in a plant. Many times I have explained, but in this question, okay, you have to explain a little more because it is long answer question. So what addition I have done in this question? Okay, it is using carbon dioxide. If it will be short question answer, then only you will write carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll and sunlight. But if this question is asking explain the process, that means carbon dioxide is taken from the air with the help of stomata. How the carbon dioxide is taken by the leaf? With the help of stomata. From where? From the air. Now next is water. Water is absorbed by the root from soil. In the soil, the water and minerals are present, and from there the root is absorbed. Okay. Presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. So in this way you have to explain a little more about the photosynthesis. Photo means light and synthesis means putting together. Okay, that means all the ingredients in the presence of sunlight are put together to make the food, which is known as photosynthesis. Okay, so I hope you all have understood how to prepare this answer. Okay, this equation is explaining more about photosynthesis. Okay, these are the ingredients, okay, which is used. But after the photosynthesis, what is prepared? It prepared glucose and it also released oxygen. Okay, it depends upon you. If you want to explain your answer more, then please add this glucose. Okay, it is prepared glucose after photosynthesis and released oxygen. If you don't want to, it's okay, just explain the ingredients and how it is taken by the plant. Okay, now third question is, explain how plants and animals are interdependent. Okay, I have explained in the previous video only, both plant is also important for human being and animal, as well as animal are also important for plants. Also, why? Because mostly for the gases, plants depend on the animals for the oxygen mostly, and when the animals die, they take the nutrients from the buried or decomposed animals. In the same way, animals and human being are depending on the plant mostly for oxygen. Okay, and then after food and shelter also. So same you have to write in your own language. Let's read this answer. Animals depend on plants for food and shelter, first number point. Second, they also take oxygen released by the plants. Okay, this is the dependency of animal on the plant. Now another line, animal, they similarly, plants also depend on animal for carbon dioxide. This is the dependency of plant on the animal. Next, they also take nutrients from decomposed animal in the soil. In this way, plant and animals both are interdependent. Okay. Now, the say aloud. The two questions are given on the page number 13. Okay, first, give an example of a food chain. There are many examples of the food chain. You can create any food chain your own, but one thing you have to keep in the mind, always and always food chain start with the plant. Okay, because plant is the producer. No other living being is capable to produce their food. Okay, you cannot start food chain with a rat or any other animal. Food chain will always and always start with the plant. You can write any example of the plant. You can write grain, you can write crops, you can write other grasses or any name of the plant, but it must be plant. And then after, the first should be one animal that depend on the plant only. Okay, that means herbivorous animals. And then after, you can write any example of the animal that eat the other animals. Okay, in this way you can create any example. I have given two examples. You can write your own example. Okay. Question number 2 is, what will happen if there is a decrease in number of plants? Okay, what will happen, have you thought? Suppose the plant is very less in amount, then you all are knowing we depend on the plant for food and the shelter, and third, oxygen. If the plant will be less in number, first we will not get sufficient amount of food, Second, we will not get wood and other plant product, and animals will not get a shelter also. Okay, because most of the animals are living in the forest or they are hiding behind the trees. If the tree and the plant will not be there, then that means their habitat or their home, their place will also be taken. So it will also spoil their home and shelter. Third, mostly we depend on the oxygen because no other organisms or living being can produce oxygen other than the plant. That's why these three main functions are there of the plant, and we depend on the plant mainly for these three things. Okay, shelter, food and oxygen. If the plant will be less in amount, then the amount of all these three things will be reduced and it will be difficult to survive on this earth. So let's read this answer. If there is a decrease in the number of plants, then the amount of oxygen will be insufficient. Insufficient means it will be not sufficient. Okay, it will be not in that much amount which is required. It will not be the adequate amount. Okay, insufficient amount for animals and human being. Animal will not get sufficient food and shelter also. Okay, so this is the answers. I hope this video will help you to write answer in your own language. But one more time I am reminding, please try to write your own answer in your way, in your language. It will enhance the writing skill. Okay, if one or two questions you are not knowing or you are not knowing how to think, that time only you should take the help. Okay, this video is only for your guidelines. Okay, thank you for watching.